Welcome to River Bend and Puppet Parade with Jasper and Baby Bird. Grandma, sing a song. And that bunch of animals with special musical guests and other funny puppets as we learn together about God's special plan for us.
Jasper! Jasper!
Here I am. What's up?
I was just wondering.
Wondering about what, Baby Bird?
Well, I was thinking about everything all at once.
I do that sometimes.
Do you get confused like I do?
Sure I do. There are lots of things to think about.
What happens when you start thinking about everything all at the same time?
In that case, I like to start over.
I'm like a broken record.
You mean like a skipping CD?
That's a modern way of looking at it.
Another way to look at overthinking is to simply pray for guidance.
You mean I need a guide?
That would help.
But who could I ask to be my guide?
That's easy. Ask Jesus.
What if I don't know what to ask Jesus for?
Remember, ask Jesus for guidance.
Help me out here, Jasper. What exactly is guidance?
It means the right direction, good advice, knowledge.
And Jesus can do all that? Even when I'm feeling down?
Yes, he can.
For me too?
Yes, he can.
Even if I don't know what to ask for?
Yes, he can. Yes, he can.
Wow. I think I just found a new direction in my life.
What you can find in Jesus, Baby Bird, will be your greatest teacher and your salvation.
Down, just call on Jesus. When you're looking for a way, ask God today. Lift up your voice to God of our salvation. Yesterday, today, forever, He's the same. Children are searching, hungry every day, looking for someone to help them grow and pray. We can be a blessing to other people, keeping the Sabbath, hallelujah. Oh Lord, please be my faithful guide today. When you're a little bit down, just call on Jesus. When you're looking for a way,
when you're looking for a way, ask God today. Lift up your voice to God of our salvation. Yesterday, today, forever, He's the same.
I'm so glad that Jesus loves me. With the plan of salvation, Jesus set us free. All the little birds are singing His praise. Every child of God can be saved.
Oh Lord, please be my faithful guide today.
When you're a little bit down, just call on Jesus.
Just call on Jesus.
When you're looking for a way,
ask God today. Lift up your voice to God of our salvation. Yesterday, today, forever, He's the same.
Those animals know how to put good feelings into words.
I didn't know Jesus could do all that.
Of course you did. Maybe you just didn't remember.
I have a bird brain, Jasper. Remember that, too.
That's not funny, Baby Bird. Don't think bad thoughts about yourself.
Well, I'm a bird, and I have a brain.
Don't worry about what other people say, Baby Bird.
Okay, I'll worry about everything else then. Okay, Jasper?
Stop your worrying and remember that Jesus is your guide.
But how do I get Jesus to guide me?
Finally, a big question with a very simple answer.
Okay, Jasper, what's the answer?
Remember to pray.
I remember now. Pray, pray, pray.
You can pray directly to Jesus.
I can? I can?
Because God gave us Jesus.
He did. He did.
There's your answer.
It is. It is.
God gave us Jesus so we could ask the Father God to answer our prayers.
In the name of Jesus.
Right, baby bird. Now you're on the right track.
I can hear you two talking. And I know a great Bible verse that might help you. Let's look up John chapter 16, verse 23. It says, "Whosoever will ask the Father in my name, he will give it to you." Now that's a great promise that Jesus gave us. When we pray, we release God's power to do wonderful things. God can open our hearts, move mountains, give blessings, and make changes. Oh, the answer is already on its way. Jesus said it, I believe it, and it's so. My Heavenly Father knows the answer before we pray. And the answer is already on its way. I found the answer, I learned to pray. With faith to guide me, I found the way. The sun is shining for me each day. I found the answer, I learned to pray. Oh, the answer's on its way, this I know. Jesus said it, I believe it, and it's so. My Heavenly Father knows the answer before we pray. And the answer is already on its way. I found the answer, I learned to pray. With faith to guide me, I found the way. The sun is shining for me each day. I found the answer, I learned to pray.
Just heard you singing that song, Grandma. Sing a song?
And so did I.
Why are you following me, Grandpa?
You're my guide to the eggs.
I'm more than a guide, Grandpa. I'm a layer.
Now, I'm glad you said that. I hope you live up to your word.
I do, every day. Have I ever let you down?
Let me down? Let's see, I'm thinking now.
Well, that would be new.
Oh, get on now.
I'm getting ready to get on with the song, Grandpa.
That means it's time for me to check on my goats.
You'd better get on your goats, Grandpa.
I've had enough of this cackle.
Grandma, why, that old farmer may be tough. I still love him. Why, he's all I've got. He does feed me and keep me in water. Now, let's play some music, and I'll croon my little song. Home, home on the farm, that's where we chickens lay our eggs. Chickens build a nest, and God does the rest, and chickens will lay eggs all day. I'm a chicken for sure, I'm not a him, I'm a her. I lay the eggs and give God the praise, we're laying our eggs on the farm. Home, home on the farm, God guides my laying of eggs. More noon nor night, he's my faithful guide. That's why I'm doing all right. My Jesus loves me, even if I can't climb a tree. He's my faithful guide, he's right by my side. He's my faithful guide.
You know, baby bird, having a guide is very helpful.
The Lone Ranger had a guide.
Who's the Lone Ranger?
He was an old Western television sheriff. His guide was named Tonto.
Tonto was his Indian guide.
He knew all about the land.
Lewis and Clark had an Indian guide, too.
They explored America all the way to the Pacific Ocean.
Can you think of any other guides, baby bird?
TV guide?
How about a real person?
That's easy. A tour guide.
I see you've been on a vacation.
I'm a frequent flyer.
What do you do when you get to a new city or town?
I pick up a guidebook.
What does the guidebook say?
It doesn't talk. It's just a book.
You know what I mean.
The guidebook shows you how to get from one place to the other.
I'll bet it also has lots of helpful hints.
It does. It does.
The guidebook for new cities and places is just like the Bible.
How could that be, Jasper?
The Bible is our guidebook for life, baby bird.
You mean it shows us the way?
It tells us how to live and tells us how to solve our problems.
Jesus told us lots of things about that in the Bible. I wonder if Jesus knows exactly what my problem is.
Remember when you said you were all mixed up about everything?
I still am, Jasper.
Just listen to this.
I'm all mixed up, I'm all mixed up. Help me find the way. I'm all mixed up, I'm all mixed up. Jesus, help me today. I'm all mixed up, I'm all mixed up. Jesus, help me to pray. I'm all mixed up, I'm all mixed up. I'll read my Bible today.
I love to go a-wandering along the mountain path.
And who's there?
Oh, it's me.
It's you.
It sure is, Grandma. Sing a song.
I heard you singing and walking.
Oh, I was. Following the mountain path, looking at all the wonderful things.
What did you see?
Well, there were lots of things. Trees, bushes, stuff like that.
Did you find anything special?
I sure did. I found, a fork in the road.
Wow! Which way did you go?
Well, I kept going the same way as I did before.
How could that be, with a fork in the road?
Well, here it is right here. It looks like a salad fork.
You fooled me that time. I thought you saw a road that forked. I mean, a road that took two different directions.
No. My road only had one direction, just with a fork in it.
Robert Frost was a great poet and wrote a poem about a path in the woods. This path is like our life. Our pathways encounter many events. The poem that Robert Frost wrote was a path that suddenly went in two directions. He wondered in the poem what directions to take. One path was very used. Lots of people took that path. The other path was less used and only had a few people. A few people went down that path in the poem. He chose the path that was less traveled and said, "That has made all the difference." Jesus can be that same pathway in your life. He can make all the difference. I like to think of Jesus as my guide. I know He can guide you down the right pathways in your life. This is a good time to introduce my very special guest, the Emmons sisters. Hi, everybody.
Hi, Grandma Sing-a-Song.
Well, we're the Emmons sisters, and I'm Christina, and I'm 15.
And I'm Victoria, and I'm 13.
I'm Natalie, and I'm 11.
And I'm Stephanie, and I'm 9.
And the song we'd like to sing is called Undeniably God.
Starting to get the idea, Jasper.
What idea, baby bird?
That Jesus is my guide.
He sure is. But how do you know for certain?
Well, God gave us Jesus as a special gift.
Do you know what that special gift was, baby bird?
I sure do, Jasper.
What was it?
God gave us Jesus to show us the way to salvation.
He is our guide. He is our gift from God.
You're right, Jasper.
Jesus died on the cross for our sins so that we can reach heaven.
Wow! That means Jesus saved us.
The Lord steers us on the right track if only we listen to Him.
I keep forgetting the good advice that the Bible tells us.
Remember to pray when you read your Bible, baby bird. Then the words will bring you comfort and joy.
I think the Bible is the best guidance I know.
If you have a question about anything, why not try the Bible first?
I'll bet it is full of answers to all my questions.
You can count on the Bible for everything you need.
good lesson, Jasper. Thanks.
Every promise in the book is mine. Every chapter, every verse, every line. I am trusting in His love divine. Every promise in the book is mine.
Every time we read the holy book, we love the Lord more and more. With each verse we memorize, there's a brand new surprise. Let us read the word and give God a try. Every promise in the book is mine. Every chapter, every verse, every line. I am trusting in His love divine. Every promise in the book is mine. Every promise in the book is mine. Every chapter, every verse, every line. I am trusting in His love divine. Every promise in the book is mine.
One more thing I forgot to tell you, baby bird.
What's that?
You have got to have faith in your guide.
If Jesus is my guide, then I also need faith?
Yes, you do.
I thought believing in Jesus was good enough.
Following the teachings of Jesus in the Bible is one thing.
What's the other thing?
You need to ask Jesus to come into your heart.
And change my life.
You need to receive Jesus.
But how do I do that?
Your faith is the answer, and your invitation is needed.
My invitation?
Yes. All you have to do is ask.
I'm ready now, Jasper.
Just open the door to your heart.
It's open now, Jasper.
Okay, then. You've opened the door to your heart.
What happens next?
What did Jesus say He would do if you just opened the door to your heart?
That He would come in?
You see how simple that was? God has given you the faith to believe His word.
I have faith, and now I have Jesus.
Thank you, Lord.
Thank you, Lord. Again.
Be my guide. Let me know your love. Take me, Lord, to your home above. Share my joy with others I see, and bless my soul, and be with me. I'll sing and praise the name of God. I'll sing and praise the name of God. I'll sing and praise the name of God. Lift my spirit and bring me home. Guide me to your heavenly throne. And when you're ready, come for me and raise me up to be with thee. I'll sing and praise the name of God. I'll sing and praise the name of God. I'll sing and praise the name of God.
Remember that your faith is more than a belief. It's a trust. It's a special promise that God has given to us through His Son, Jesus Christ. And everyone who opens their hearts and asks Jesus into their heart will have a God-given guide through this life and to eternal salvation. I think Jesus had a great promise. He would return to us. Jesus told us in the Bible He would return. Here's a song about the return of Jesus called "The Meeting in the Air."
Mm-hmm.
There's going to be a meeting in the air in that sweet, sweet by and by. I'm going to meet you over there in that home beyond the sky. Such singing you will hear, never heard by mortal ear, will be glorious, I do declare. And God's own Son will be the leading one at that meeting in the air.
Wow, I want to be a part of that meeting, Jasper.
So do I, baby bird.
I didn't know God had such a great plan, Jasper.
It's all in the Bible. Just pick up the Bible and read.
Good idea, Jasper. Where do I look?
Let's see. Start with the Book of Mark, chapter 11, verse 22.
What does that say?
And Jesus answered them, "Have faith in God."
Have faith in God. How simple that is. Why, I should have thought of that at the very beginning. If I just have faith in God, then I don't need to worry so much, Jasper.
You see, baby bird, Jesus is our guide. Be faithful to him, and your life will be wonderful.
I should have known that all along.
If your guide is Jesus,
and I'm faithful to Jesus,
then Jesus is your faithful guide.
I just need to be faithful to Jesus.
And Jesus can help you with your faith.
Wow. That's as easy as pie.
You must be getting hungry.
Why do you say that?
You said pie.
I said faith can be as easy as pie.
Oh, I thought you said apple pie.
No, no, I would have said cherry pie.
But I like blueberry pie.
And I like pecan pie.
How about pumpkin pie?
Okay, Jasper, what rhymes with pie?
Bye.
Right. Bye-bye.
As in, bye-bye, everybody?
Bye-bye, everybody. Bye-bye.
Post Office Box 766, Grants Pass, Oregon 97528.